We have the only technology in the world that can separate and purify these critical and rare earth elements that are needed for defense applications as well as commercial applications. And seeing India, Japan, and the United States all coming together to establish this partnership as well as Australia is huge. We have partners already in these locations.
Hello, you're watching Proactive. I'm joined by American Resources CEO Mark Jensen. Mark, great to speak with you again. You've applauded the Quad Critical Minerals Initiative. How does this international collaboration enhance ReElement's ability to localize refining and compete globally?
Yeah, I mean, I think the idea that we're going to be able to solve all of our own critical mineral needs from our own borders is impossible. So we need overseas collaboration and partnerships to be able to source these raw materials. And what's really attractive about our technology at ReElement Technologies, which is owned by American Resources, is the ability to deploy locally. We have the only technology in the world that can separate and purify these critical and rare earth elements that are needed for defense applications as well as commercial applications. And seeing India, Japan, and the United States all coming together to establish this partnership as well as Australia is huge. We have partners already in these locations, and now seeing the government also supporting these initiatives just ties really well into what we're doing at our operations.
Well, as you mentioned, Mark, you've signed agreements across the Quad Nations and beyond. Can you share more about how these partnerships are progressing and then what's next?
Yeah, so in Australia, we're working with a partner. We haven't announced that one yet, but they are using our technology to separate and purify their rare earth elements. What's awesome about it is we lowered their cost by about 70% in terms of building out separation capacity and being able to produce more materials. In Africa, not part of the Quad partnerships, but we have Navarre has committed $100 million for our facility there, which we'll own the majority of, which is a huge deal. In Japan, we partnered on the battery side as well as working on the magnet side there for the full critical mineral supply chain, which enables us to do that. We've announced two partnerships in India with Exego as well as Loham for battery materials as well as magnet materials for the rare earth elements and the critical minerals. So they're all moving forward. We got a lot of team members that are driving these initiatives and making it happen.
Mark, what makes ReElement's technology so much faster and more efficient than traditional refining methods?
Absolutely. So traditional refining is solvent extraction. It's a really toxic chemical-to-chemical separation, creating vapors and water discharge, which are really bad, hard to get permitted. It takes years. I mean, there's a company called Linus that took $283 million from the government that's trying to get permitted in the U.S., and because they use solvent, it's tough to do. Our technology is using chemical-to-solid separation, which we build via columns inside warehouses, and so it enables us to move really rapidly. I mean, I refine next to a kids' gymnasium in a church today in the United States, producing heavy rare earth oxides. But using our technology, it's modular, scalable, and deployable, which needs very little utilities or water that we can't recycle. We can recycle all that stuff. So it enables us to move very quickly into very remote regions as well as urban areas.
Which critical minerals or defense applications are you seeing the strongest demand for right now? And how is ReElement's positioned to meet that?
Yeah, so this is a samarium cobalt magnets are a majority of the magnets actually used by the defense industry. We produce samarium, we produce gadolinium, which is an yttrium, which are used for high heat applications, antimony trisulfide, which everything that goes boom, basically the missiles, the bullets, need antimony to harden that lead in those missile applications. We also produce gallium and terbium for crystal growth, for lasers, optics, and drones. A wide variety of materials that nobody really knows about. Everybody thinks about neodymium, praseodymium, dysprosium, which go into neodymium-based magnets, which is used to a very small degree in the military applications. All these other esoteric defense metals are really the key drivers of which we produce today.
The Export-Import Bank's $150 million letter of interest is a major milestone. How do you plan to deploy that capital to support cross-border expansion, Mark?
Yeah, it's so we just had a great call with XM yesterday. Phenomenal team there. Super excited to work with them. Just lowering our cost of capital, extending out the duration of notes is a big deal. Our goal is to build out capacity specifically for the defense industry here domestically, as well as working with a group called Pensana, which is a mine in South Africa we have that's also working on applications there with the U.S. government to deploy our technology to their site, as well as refine their materials here. So just expanding capacity. I mean, our goal is to make rare earth and critical minerals no longer rare and no longer critical because they're abundantly available.
Mark, I hope you'll continue to keep us updated with your progress. Thank you very much for speaking with us today.
Awesome. Thank you for having us on.
Very welcome. Mark Jensen, CEO of American Resources.